As if the trolley picture isn't bad enough, now East-West Gateway, that handles a lot of the local requests for federal funds, is saying it may get even worse for taxpayers if the trolley folds. East-West says if the project fails, taxpayers could have to repay some of the millions of federal transportation agency put up to build the system. Big alarm bells for officials like St. Louis County Executive Sam Page.
Is that going to change the dynamics if we have to end up paying back tens of millions of dollars?
Well, it certainly changes the conversation. There may be a loan here that's going to come due, so we need to have a real understanding about who owns it.
The trolley company asked the county for $700,000 to stay afloat, warning it could shut down without the money. The county already gave $3 million to the project before. Sam Page says enough is enough, telling the trolley not to expect more money from the county.
Would there be a catastrophe if the loop trolley had to shut down?
No, I think that would not be a catastrophe. It would be unfortunate and it would be sad because it was an idea that, when properly managed, could have worked. But I think what would be a catastrophe is if we end up owing a lot of money.
The trolley's main backer, Joe Edwards, is hoping the worst can be avoided.
Hopefully the county council will do its part. I know the city of St. Louis is looking for funding.
So I'm not in favor of St. Louis County providing those funds. There's a lot of unknowns. If someone else wants to come in, a private source or another public source, and support them.
You can't get private dollars to do this?
Well, a lot of private money's come into it already.
But will you need $700,000 more? Can't you get that?
If you can get it for us, that'd be great.
Board President Lewis Reed says, don't look at the city for money if he can help it.
Do you think the city has money to be able to give the loop trolley any money?
Here, from my perspective, that answer is the easy answer, no. But, I have no idea where they would find it. But if they indeed find some money, that first money needs to go to address the public safety issues within our city.
Have you tried private sources to get this money? And what have they told you?
A lot of them have given money.
Can they kick in $700,000 more?
Well, not at this point.
Meanwhile, Sam Page trying to see just how bad this is going to get.
I want to understand what our debt to the federal government is. I want to understand what our legal liabilities are, which we may not completely know. And I want to understand what the long-term plan is for the trolley, because the plan so far hasn't materialized as we had hoped.
Troubles on the trolley. The head of East-West Gateway is hoping the feds will let them know as soon as tomorrow how much money the feds would want paid back if the trolley fails, and just who would have to pay. Right now, the trolley operating on a reduced schedule to try and conserve cash. Of course, I'll keep you up on this expensive deal that could get costlier after all. You paid for it.
Well, the trolley hasn't even been operating for a full year. How did things get so bad so quickly? Was it they just simply didn't have as many riders as they predicted? And I know they did have some mechanical issues.
Well, that certainly is one of the issues, couldn't get enough riders. Joe Edwards says they couldn't get all the trolleys in on time. They expected to run 7 days a week. He said if they'd gotten the trolleys on time, they would have run 7 days a week and the revenue would have been there. Critics say, as you just said, they just couldn't get enough riders, and it wouldn't have mattered if they had that third trolley. They said it wouldn't have made a difference at all.
Well, it's something that a lot of people are talking about, so it's going to be interesting to see how it all pans out.
And, of course, it'd be a mess if taxpayers had to pay back millions of dollars to the feds.
All right.
Insult to injury.
Yeah. All right, Elliot, thank you.
All right.